So, using fresh, clean drinking water is what we flush with to dispose of your tissue when you blow your nose. That, if we eliminate that, that's a tremendous change. One of the things I tell kids is how much water we use from the faucet. Well, they all know, what do you do when you're brushing your teeth? That can say, you brush your teeth for 2 minutes, and the water is running at about 2 gallons per minute. 2 times 2, 4. 4 in the morning, 4 at night. That is easy 8, or water for the butterflies. Multiply that times the average classroom size of 30 kids, that's 240 gallons. Multiply that times 365 days in a year. I think the answer is 68,000. I'll have it memorized. 295. That's huge from one simple practice change. So a lot of these problems can be, simple practice changes can make a huge difference. That water that we use, half of that 138 or 134, wherever that number is, that approximately, let's say, 65 to 70 gallons of water each day that we flush or we shower or we wash our clothes or we cook with, that has to be treated and that has to go somewhere. So right now, it's treated to a pretty high degree of you know, contaminants are removed. What we can't remove are pharmaceutical residuals that are in our wastewater. Right now, that is still being released as ocean outfall. And EPA mandated that we needed to come up with a system and stop doing that by 2015. But we were not far enough along on solving that, so they pushed the date back. I think it's 2022 now. What they're talking about doing is deep well injection, of it injecting it back down into the ground. Where do we get our drinking water from again? Biscayne Aquifer. They're going to deep inject it below the Biscayne Aquifer. And hopefully they'll miss the Florida aquifer also. I don't know what the solution is for that, because here's the thing. We can't stop going to the bathroom. That just wouldn't work. But we can just take those 5-minute showers. When you're in the kitchen cooking and you're filling this pot up and you walk over to turn the water off before you go. You know, just be diligent about not running the water when, you know, to me, somebody, a running faucet or a leak is like scratching your fingernails on a blackboard wall. I said, turn it off. You know, don't waste it. It is Fix a Leak Week, declared by the EPA. And when we're talking about water that goes down the drain, one little drip, drop, leak from the faucet, one drop per second, can be 3,154 gallons of water down the drain in a year. So each year, it's estimated that we lose 6 trillion gallons of water to leaks in the United States. So I wonder how many of those African countries that are below the water poverty line could benefit from 6 trillion gallons of water. So that's water that is unnecessarily being cleaned and injected. We have to figure out what to do with it. Irrigate efficiently or use water wisely, however you want to say it. And then mulching and protecting, attracting, planting for wildlife, attracting wildlife, protecting the waterfront. You know, using pesticides carefully. Is it really an insect that's causing the problem? Does it need to take that step to use a chemical to try to eliminate it? And if it does need to be taken care of, what is the proper product and the application? So what's the right way to do that? It's like you don't want to take antibiotics every time you don't feel good. So you find out what you need to do and what it is. You identify. Sometimes it's a cultural or practice change, like you may have plants clumped too closely together. Right now you're seeing sooty black mold because whitefly is around, and the sooty black mold, which is produced from the droppings of whitefly, is kind of covering the leaves because we haven't had any rainfall to wash it off. And also, a good spritz with a hose underneath the leaves will knock those white flies out of place. And ladybugs are starting to come in to their peak time. So ladybugs, you won't see them in your yard unless they have something to eat. They love eating that white fly larvae. So a word to the wise, if you release ladybugs in your yard and they all fly away, they flew off looking for food. And all of nature kind of has a check and balance system. Where we get into problems with insects are when they're not native. They've been introduced, they've been accidentally brought in, and the natural system of predators is not there to do the check and balance. And even those are sometimes just briefly, seasonally a problem. Turning it over again. Now, I hope I don't move too much more because I'm getting old for gardening. So how to save water, you can find more ways that Miami-Dade Water and Sewer actually will help by reimbursements and different programs for greater needs. So you guys are way too old for DVOM. Yeah. But we can install a rain barrel at your school. Do you have a garden?
We had four.
You're going to get a rain barrel today. Is in your packet of information. And also, we have it up on the website, or I will send it to you in color, in full detail. Now, hey, can somebody get me a rain barrel off the trailer? We'll actually.